Now, it's my pleasure to introduce Mr. Deepjoy Sewer, and he is the head of the cloud advisory practice at Larsen and Tobro Infotech. And Mr. Deepjoy is going to share his experience about how Larsen and Tobro has transformed the way they run SAP on AWS. And I've got to say, there's nothing like hearing from a customer that drinks their own champagne. Mr. Deepjoy.
Thank you, David, for the introduction. And it's my pleasure, guys, to come and talk to you from a customer perspective out here today. And it's very important, right? So innovation is one thing we as a company at LTI keeps us in business, right? The agility, the speed of innovation, all of these are very critical for us. And one thing we have realized is that SAP S4 environment, which we run, is the core to our business. We call it our digital core. And moving our digital core to AWS in itself was the first challenge which we took. We migrated the entire system in, I would say, about 2.5 months, which is a record in itself. David was mentioning about timelines and the other things which other customers have done. We have moved it in 2.5 months. And then running the system, that's where the innovation and agility comes in, right? So you innovate once, you innovate again and again, because AWS comes up with tools and technologies which helps you to innovate and run your environment, your landscape in such a way that you do innovation every day to constantly keep up the curve of innovation. So the level of innovation today is more than what you used to do yesterday, and tomorrow will be better. That's the whole premise. So previously we had a challenge, and I will share you a real challenge, right? So SAP system refreshes. We used to talk about system refreshes in weeks. I remember when I started my first SAP project about 10 years back, we talked about refreshes running in weeks. When we did our first refresh, we took about a couple of days on AWS. Then we started to think, how do we do our refreshes faster? Currently, we do our full production refresh in less than 8 hours of time. And our aim is to do it in 4 hours, right? And how do we do that? AWS brings you that whole platform to innovate. It's not just the instances, it's not just the landscapes. There are certain other things apart from that, like the AWS serverless architectures, the Lambda functions, a lot of step functions which we use, which will basically run your entire refresh process in seamlessly humanless manner. And we are into the next level wherein we do post-refresh validation also through automated manner, right? So, and that's the level of innovation we are talking about, and constant optimization of the environment. And that's what we are loving it, because we are not bound to an infrastructure, right? So we run an application, we run a platform for the business. And what's important is that I shouldn't care about the infrastructure underlying. We shut down the infrastructure when we don't need it. We bring it up. There is a sequence of processes which we follow, and that's what gives us more agility and flexibility. So I think from our perspective, it's a win-win, because we innovate, we accelerate, and it gives our business more agility to run mission-critical workloads on AWS like S4 HANA. Thank you.